In this lecture, we study about the small signal AC models of the field effect transistors, and this is discussed in the chapter 9 of Leonard S. Bobrow. In our previous lectures, we have studied about the small signal models of a BJT. When an AC signal is coupled to a DC source in the BJT circuit, we have seen that there are two ways of analyzing this circuit. One is the graphical method and the other is to use the principle of superposition. If you remember, in the graphical method, if this is the characteristics of your BJT, the collector characteristics, then over this, the AC signal is superimposed, and then the variations of your potential and the current because of the addition of this AC components are studied. And from this graphical method, you can obtain the required parameters and use them to calculate the dynamic resistance and the conductance of your BJT. Third was the use of the principle of superposition. If you remember, if you couple the AC and DC components using a coupling capacitor, this allows us to separately analyze the DC circuit and the AC circuit. That is, basically you get your DC parameters and the AC parameters, and then you can use the principle of, using the principle of superposition, you get the total value of these parameters. And in this, we have seen that the DC analysis gives you the Q point, and the AC components could be obtained by considering equivalent AC circuits. These equivalent AC circuits were analyzed using small signal AC models, and in this model, in this modeling, we replace the non-linear circuit elements like our BJTs and now the FETs with linear elements, which allow us to analyze this AC circuit. In this process, we make certain assumptions, and the assumptions were the AC components are very small, that is, the transistor, so that the transistor always operates in the active region all the time. And the second one was the non-linearities arising due to the nature of these devices becomes very insignificant when we consider these small signal AC components. So with these two assumptions, we could do the small signal AC modelings of a BJT, and we have studied three different models of BJTs. In this lecture, we will look at some small signal AC models for FETs. The generic symbol for a FET is shown here. It's got a gate, it's got a drain, it got a source, and it has got VDS, it has got VGS, and it shows ID. And notice that all these are indicated by small alphabets to denote that we are looking at the AC components of the circuit. So now, looking at the characteristics of these elements and looking at the interdependencies of the potentials between the gate, drain, gate, source, etc., we know the general behavior of these elements, and we can model these based on the characteristics or the properties we know of these devices. For example, the gate source offers an infinite resistance. So this could be modeled, the gate could be modeled by a resistance. The drain, because it gives you the output current, it can be modeled by a current source. So we can do we can analyze the properties of these, and based on that, we can replace this with linear elements like a resistor, a current source, or a voltage source. These could be most of the times these will be dependent sources. So let us look at two models of for your field effect transistors. From the general characteristics of your field effect transistors, we know that the resistance between the gate and the source is infinity. So we can represent the gate by a resistor which has got a high value of resistance, or by an open circuit. And from the characteristics, we know that the drain current ID does not change with change in VDS. Remember, we are working in the active region. We are looking at amplifiers, and we want to model these for amplifying processes. So that means our transistors are working in active region, and we know that in the active region the drain current saturates, that is, for changing values of VDS it is not going to change much. So the fact that your AC component VDS is added, that's an incremental, very tiny change to your DC component. So those values are not really going to affect the drain current, and which also includes your AC component of the drain current. So we know that ID is independent of VDS, but we also know from the drain characteristics that the drain current depends on VGS values. So for a small signal AC model of a FET, the AC component of the drain current ID will be proportional to VGS, and the drain can be represented by a voltage controlled current source, where the voltage is VGS and the current will be the ID. Thus, this allows us to model our field effect transistors as shown in these two figures. In the first figure, we see that the resistance, the gate is represented by a resistor whose resistance is denoted is almost equal to infinity, very high, and the drain is represented by a voltage dependent current source, and we can see that it depends on VGS, and this is the source. Now, because this R is infinity, we can actually represent it by a open circuit as shown in this symbol. So removing the gate and replacing it with an open circuit will transform this circuit to this circuit, or this model to this model. And here we can see that GM is known as the transconductance of the FET and is obtained as a ratio of the drain current divided by the drain current and the VGS. And we know that these are nothing but incremental changes in your the DC components of the drain current and the DC component of the potential VGS. So GM can be obtained by DID by DVGS, and we know that for a JFET or a depletion MOSFET, depletion type MOSFET, your drain current is given by this expression. Substituting this here, we get GM is equal to minus 2 IDSS by VP into 1 minus VGS by VP. I hope you remember VP is the pinch off voltage. And from the equation of the drain current, 1 minus VGS by VP is nothing but root of ID by IDSS, and substituting this reduces your transconductance expression to minus 2 by VP root of ID into IDSS. And if we look at the special case where VGS is equal to 0, the transconductance is given by GM0 is equal to minus 2 IDSS divided by VP. That is, it is just the ratio of the saturation current of the JFET and the depletion type MOSFET divided by the pinch off voltage. And it should be noted that for all practical reasons or purposes, for these FETs, the transconductance at VGS is equal to 0 and IDSS are measured more accurately compared to your VP. So using this equation, where one can measure the transconductance for the case where VGS is equal to 0 and the saturation current IDSS, we can obtain a more accurate value of the pinch off potential. And we can also write the transconductance in terms of GM0 as GM is equal to GM0 root of ID by IDSS. So this shows us for a JFET or a depletion type MOSFET, how we can calculate one of the crucial parameters of the device, namely the transconductance. And using this transconductance, we can calculate the resistance of the device, which is nothing but the reciprocal of the transconductance. Next, we do a similar analysis for the enhancement type MOSFET and obtain its transconductance expression. We all know that for an enhancement type MOSFET, the drain current expression is given by ID is equal to K into VGS minus VT whole square, where VT is a threshold potential and K is a constant which depends on the device parameters. And the transconductance can be obtained using this expression, where we substitute ID in the expression for GM and we obtain 2K into VGS minus VT. Again, using the expression for the drain current, we can simplify the expression for the transconductance to Gm is equal to 2 into root of K into Id. But then Id is equal to K into VGS minus VT whole square, which implies your K is equal to Id by VGS minus VT whole square. Thus, the transconductance can be written as Gm is equal to 2Id by VGS minus VT. And it is known that the value of the transconductance for the FETs lies between 10 power minus 4 to 2 into 10 power minus 2. So this is one model of FETs where we have obtained the expression for the transconductance. In the next slide, we are going to look at another model. In this model, in addition to replacing the gate by an open circuit and the drain by a voltage dependent current source, we add a resistor RD in parallel with the current source. Now, we know that current sources, if they are non-ideal, will have an internal resistance, and we know that there are no ideal sources. So, for a more accurate model, we can add a resistor RD so that the accuracy of our model improves. Applying KCL to this node here, we get Id is equal to Gm VGS plus VDS by RD. And the transconductance can be obtained by putting VDS is equal to 0 for fixed DC component VDS, and Gm turns out to be Id by VGS. And we can obtain the drain, this RD, by putting VGS is equal to 0 for fixed VGS, and RD turns out to be VDS by ID, which from the characteristics can be written as dVDS by dID, where we are considering the DC components. And it has been found that for JFETs, RD is equal to 100 ohms, and for MOSFETs, RD is equal to 10 kilo ohms. So in this lecture, we have looked at two small signal AC models for FETs, and we will conclude this lecture by doing a problem. Let us look at the common source amplifier, which is discussed in example 99.8. It is called a common source amplifier because the source is common to the input as well as the output. And for this circuit, we are going to use the small signal AC models we have studied and calculate the gain in the voltage. So if you look at this circuit, here the DC voltage source and the AC voltage source are coupled using the coupling capacitor C here. And in addition, there is another capacitor which is connected to your source. As far as the DC is concerned, once the capacitors are charged, they are like open circuits. So for analyzing the DC part of the circuit, we can neglect this part of the circuit. So if therefore the circuit which is shown in this square box can be analyzed, and you will get your Q point. Now once the Q point is done, now we look at the AC part of the circuit or the AC components of the circuit. And we know that for AC signals, these capacitors act as short circuits. So we just replace these capacitors by short circuits. And when we do that, this R1 and R2 will become parallel to each other, which are given by the equivalent resistance, resistor RP. And because this is now a short circuit, the current will pass through this path rather than this path. So we can remove the resistance RS. So the equivalent AC circuit for your JFET circuit is given here. Now we will make use of the small signal models we have studied and then try to obtain the gain. So first we will use the small signal AC model which was discussed in the figure 9.37, and here we replace the JFET where the gate is replaced by the open circuit and the drain is replaced by a voltage dependent current source. So with this you can see that the VDS, which is nothing but the voltage drop here, is equal to minus RDID. And we know that ID is equal to GM VGS. And this is dependent on the potential VGS. So substituting that gives us VDS is equal to minus RD GM VGS. And the gain in the voltage can be obtained by is nothing but the ratio between the drain potential divided by the gate potential, which is nothing but VDS by VGS, which is, once you substitute this expression, you get the gain is equal to minus GM by RD. Now, let us use the model which was discussed in figure 9.37, where an additional resistance RD is placed parallel with the current source and now parallel with the resistance capital RD. So this is your resistance RD, and these are parallel to each other. So we can replace these two with the equivalent resistance, which is given by RD capital RD divided by small RD plus capital RD. And the gain will be with this replaced by this equivalent resistance will be nothing but AV is equal to minus GM into RD capital RD divided by RD plus RD. Now, for the JFET amplifier we have considered, the given parameters are these. The saturation current is 10 milliamps, the pinch off voltage is minus 4 volts, the DC source is at 15 volts, the values of R1, R2, RS and RD are given, and VGS is minus VTQ, and the Q point is obtained here. Your ID is equal to minus 2.5 milliamps. So the transconductance now can be obtained for these given values, which is GM is equal to minus 2IDSS by VP into 1 minus VGS by VP, which turns out to be 2.5 milliohm inverse. So this, for these values of the parameters for your JFET, the transconductance turns out to be this. Now let us look at the gain for both the small signal models we have studied. So the AV in the case where there is a resistance RD in parallel with the capital RD, AV is equal to minus GM into this. And we can see that when RD is ignored, that is when RD tends to infinity, in this expression, you have to do a binomial expansion and you will just end up with minus GM by RD. And for this case, your AV turns out to be minus 2.5. The gain is minus 2.5. Whereas when you consider RD, and for a JFET, RD is given as 100 kilo ohms, then RD parallel to RD, the equivalent resistance turns out to be 990 ohms. And this, when substituted in your gain expression, AV turns out to be minus 2.48. Thus, we have seen that how using small signal AC models, it is easy to analyze the AC equivalent circuits, and using those circuits, we can calculate the parameters associated with your amplifier circuits. So with this, we finished the lecture on the small signal AC models for your field effect transistors.